Start right from the beginning, okay. So dark matter is stuff like the matter that we know. Matter is defined by how it interacts with gravity. So matter is stuff that attracts other matter and clumps, or it's attracted by any form of energy and it clumps together to form structures like galaxies, etc. The difference between dark matter and the matter we're familiar with is that the matter we're familiar with interacts via what's called the Standard Model forces, including electromagnetism, such as light. So ordinary matter interacts with light, but as far as we know, dark matter does not, which means it's made up of other stuff. It's not made up of the things that you and I are made up of. It's made up of completely different matter. So it's matter in the sense that it interacts gravitationally like matter, but it's not the familiar matter that's made up of atoms, for example. We propose that, basically we don't know what dark matter is. People have assumed for a long time that they think they know that it has something to do with the Standard Model, and maybe even a particular extension of the Standard Model. And in those cases, which you call WIMPs, there is an interaction, which is very small, with ordinary matter. We ask the question, suppose there is no such interaction, so you'll never find it through the traditional searches. What could dark matter be that we might still be able to observe? So our proposal is that maybe dark matter interacts with itself. It doesn't mean that we know this is correct, or maybe even some of the dark matter, not all of the dark matter, interacts with itself. And we ask the question, if it's not interacting directly with us, but only with itself, would there be detectable signs in the structure of galaxies, in the structure of matter, that can tell us that those interactions exist so that we would know about them? Well, it's a very, it's speculative, but the idea is that maybe if some of the dark matter interacts, it collapses to form a dark matter disk. The same way we have the Milky Way plane, which is formed by ordinary matter. The reason that happens is because matter radiates and collapses. Maybe dark matter does the same thing. And if that's the case, maybe the solar system experiences the effects of dark matter every 30 or 35 million years as the solar system passes through the Milky Way plane. So the solar system orbits around the galaxy, but it bobs up and down as it does that. And so our suggestion is maybe every 30 or 35 million years, it's more likely that gravity would trigger comet strikes, particularly from the distant objects in the Oort cloud, which are thousands of times farther away from the sun than the Earth, and therefore very weakly gravitationally bound. And it turns out that 66 million years ago, a big object hit the Earth, triggering the dinosaur extinction and extinction of most of life on Earth. And so we suggest maybe this was triggered by the solar system going through the dark matter plane.